Third and orange.
Four.
How many? How many?
Four.
How many seeds? How many? We don't know. You know what? You want how many seeds are in an orange? You know what you do? You cut it open and you count them, right? That's pretty easy. It might be 10, it might be 4, it might be 6, depends upon the orange. But I'm not concerned with how many seeds are in an orange. I wonder how many oranges are in a seed. Have you ever thought about that?
There's two.
How many oranges in a seed? We can take a seed and we can plant the seed and a tree will grow. And if it's an orange seed, what will be on that tree?
Oranges,
of course. And what will be in those oranges? More seeds. And we can plant those seeds and get more trees and get more oranges. We don't know. Now, we can count how many seeds are in an orange, but we never know how many oranges are in a seed. That just is amazing. You know what this is? No, it's a bucket.
A smiley face bucket.
It does have a smiley face. He's a happy bucket. He's happy to be in church this morning. All right, here's a bucket. And the beautiful thing is, we can plant seeds. Did you know that? We can plant physical seeds. You can cut open an orange and plant the orange seeds. Or we can plant seeds of kindness. And we don't know how much kindness is going to come out of one seed of kindness. Come here, sweetheart. Stand right there. Face the front. Now, I have a seed. What's your name? Are you? Are you married? Why are you laughing? Have you met her husband? Well, I have a seed of kindness. I can take a seed of kindness. Hold your hand out. I can give you a seed of kindness. Maybe I could help you with some chores. Or maybe I could just say something nice and be encouragement. Maybe you fall down and I help you. I can plant a seed of kindness right there. And you know what happens when I plant that seed of kindness? It grows. It grows. We can plant the seed of kindness in others and it will grow. That is amazing. We'll just put that in our bucket there. So now we got one in the bucket money. But and then of course there's I plant kindness in her. I can plant a seed of kindness. Come here, young man. What's your name? Christopher.
Hello, Christopher.
Turn around, look at the funny people. That's what I get to look at this morning. What do you think about that? Hold your hand out. But I can. Kids could do something kind for Christopher. He might be having a bad day. He's feeling bad. People have been picking on him and giving him a hard time. She can come up and give him a hug. Look him up. She can come up and give him a hug. Say, it's all right, Christopher. You're a good one. She can plant a seed of kindness right there. And not because he has received that seed of kindness, he's feeling good, right? He was feeling bad. He didn't want to help anybody. Things are tough. But now, not only has he received kindness, but he has kindness he can give. He can put that in the bucket, okay? So we can give kindness. And, I get Tennessee, what are you doing? So I can do something kind for you that. Okay, well, I can do some kind for her, and the kindness just keeps multiplying over. All right. The kindness just keeps multiplying and multiplying and multiplying, and because of one seed of kindness, we could have a whole bucket full of. Okay, well, we could have had a whole bucket full of kindness. But there's another seed we can plant too. The Bible says the Word of God is a seed. Jesus told a parable, a story, a similitude about a man that planted scattered seeds and some grew and some didn't. And he said that seed is the Word of God. Now, we know what the Bible is. We have Bibles. This is a tract. You know, you can probably get a couple of these from Pastor Mike, and you can give these to people. And they tell you how to know Jesus. they tell you how, this one says, how to get to heaven from Kentucky. And I could give it to her, and she could read it. She could read it. Then she could pass it on to the next person, and they could read it. And they could come to know Jesus, and they could pass it on. The next person gets to know Jesus. And then he loses, but he remembers what it says. So he tells two other people what it said. And they tell two other people. And, you know, suddenly, you know, we're planting tracks. We're putting tracks. There's another one. And we just keep planting the seed. And we keep planting the seed. And pretty soon, you know what happens? We have Christians everywhere. Well, wait a minute, there's one.
Come here.
Now, look, let's look it over. You can hold things over. There's one. And because he shared the gospel, someone else got saved. And because he skinned some of the tracks, someone else got saved. And she told two people about Jesus. Where did this all come from? We don't know how many seeds are in the orange. We don't know how many oranges are in that seed. We don't know how many Christians can come for one Bible study. They just keep coming! And it just multiplies and multiplies and multiplies. Whoa! That's incredible!
Yep.
How did you do that? You ever see, honey? So, it started with one seed, and then we had two seeds. And guys, you can go out and you can plant two kinds of seeds today. You can plant seeds of kindness. And you know, when someone's good to me, I want to be good to someone else. And when you also plant the Word of God, you can go home and tell your neighbors about Jesus being in the Bible church. You can tell kids at school, you know what I heard? I heard you can get to heaven from Kentucky. And I found out loud you can give them a tract or tell them maybe what the tract says or share your favorite Bible verse. And it just keeps multiplying. The Word of God multiplies. It's amazing. You know what? Jesus started with 12 people. It was Jesus and his 12 buddies, the 12 disciples. You've heard of them, right? One of them was Judas, and he went totally off the rails. That left Jesus and the 11 disciples. Jesus, after his resurrection, went to heaven. That left 11 disciples. But out of those 11 disciples, there are now millions of Christians in the world. And there have been millions of Christians over the years. Out of 11. There might have only been 11 seeds in that orange. Boy, those 11 seeds exploded. Okay? And I want to share that with you. I want you to think about that. That one kind act, or that one gospel tract you handed out, can change not only one person's life, but the lives of all the people they come in contact with. It's mind-boggling. 11 people build this world Christians. Now,